Okay, so welcome everybody. It's really wonderful to see all of you here for the, I think it's for the first time, in fact, in the last year that I'm seeing so many people in this hall. I have to say that I'm incredibly proud of this this particular year that we succeeded in continuing with our program. This was a difficult decision for ICTP, but we were really determined to bring all our students from all over the world here. I know that it was a very difficult year for you also, and you should be proud of yourself for you know, coming out of it successfully. I know that the difficulties were from all kinds, being away in this very strange times in a new country, in a way being confined to the guest house. If it has been a success, it's really thanks to the great colleagues that we have at ICTP, and especially the coordinators, as you know, Professor Chalani, Professor Goche, Professor Farnetti, Professor Criminelli, and Professor Kisseler, and of course Patrizia and Sandra. They have been, together with the medical section and all the other team that actually worked here quite hard just to keep the COVID regulations in place. There was a COVID response team. They were meeting every week to really make sure that your safety is guaranteed. I know that many people had dietary restrictions or all kinds of personal difficulties, and I hope that ICTP really supported you, and I hope you had a good time here. It is difficult to connect with your friends also here, which is one of the best aspects of ICTP's life. But I think, I do hope that you made good friends here. And as some of the speakers said, as you must have seen, your year is special for two reasons. I mean, one is that, of course, we are living through this strange time, so you are the COVID year, in a way, second COVID year, but also because of the 30th year. And you have seen how deeply people feel connected to ICTP, even those who have left 20 years ago. It was really wonderful to see people who have gone on to become, and some of you will, I'm sure all of you will flourish in your own chosen field, but you saw that a whole broad spectrum of people going from work in theoretical physics to becoming a minister in their own country, or being a vice president of a finance company. So all these doors are open to you, and I do hope that you will, ICTP will remain in your hearts, and we will remain connected. I think that was part of the reason for this reunion, that we really want to build this community and keep it as a community, as a family, for the years to come, so that you have friends, colleagues, and mentors, you know, to guide you, to support you throughout your career. So I would like to give now the floor. So thank. So congratulations, first of all, I have to say to all of you. I guess we will congratulate each of you individually. And I have to say that this is one of the most, personally for me also, of course, my own research is important, but when I see the graduation ceremony and how diverse is our student body, it's one of the moments where I really feel proud of ICTP's mission. So congratulations once again. I would like to give the floor to Professor Misha Kisseler, particularly because of the role that he has played. Unfortunately, Professor George Thompson could not make it today. He will also represent George, but also he played a very important role in coordinating all these activities during the COVID times. So please, Misha, I would request you to.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Can you hear me? Yeah. Well, I'm going to be short. It's sort of improvised speech. And first of all, I would like to congratulate all of you with your success. This day is very important for you. You are graduated today, and you are heroes of this day. So it was a difficult year, indeed. I remember that students start to arrive middle of September, and start arriving, stay in self-isolation, learn many things in the self-isolation. Then we started program, and some of students were still connected being in their home countries. You, I think, learned many things. The year was difficult, and my feeling is more difficult than the previous one. But as you learn something from your senior colleagues, we also learned a lot this year. We learned how to teach in this hybrid form when part of the audience is online and part of the audience is present. We learned how to increase the interaction between students and lecturers, because interaction is very important. You know, science in general and theoretical physics in particular is based on personal contacts. So people learn more through the personal contacts. So by congratulating you, I would also like to thank you, all students, for your devotion and your patience. Most of the time, you were staying in one of the guest houses. You were using ICTP facilities, but it was really unusual, both for you and for ICTP. Second, I would like to personally thank Patrizia and Sandra, and I think they deserve applauses. And I would like to thank all ICTP team. I apologize if I forgot to mention some people or offices, but I'm thankful to housing because they provide for you very friendly and very efficient environment to live and work. I would like to thank ICTS, our computer section, for providing you constant support in the time when you learn things. I would like to thank all the lecturers who helped you to learn theoretical physics. And in particular, I would like to thank supervisors, those who are present here in this Budinich lecture hall, and those who are not present, for their personal help to you to mature in physics. I would like to thank your tutor, our young generation, our postdocs, and also to thank your family members for your support during this difficult time. And of course, I would like to thank the ICTP director for constant support and a very efficient way to solve problems, in particular, problem with food and other problems. So thank you very much. No, we start with high energy, I think.
Okay, good to see you. So I join the congratulations. By the way, I'm not the coordinator of the high energy diploma, but Giovanni Villadoro could not be here, so I'm substituting him. Okay, so we are going to hand one by one the diploma. Let me start with Abdelrahman Al-Megari. He's from Palestine. And the title of his thesis was Top Quark Pair Production with the Atlas Experiment under the supervision of Bobby Acharya, who is not here today. Ah, sorry. Okay. So the process is that the director will give the thesis and that's it. And then there is the photograph in the center. And the student, come down.
Yeah, we can do namaste, since we cannot shake hands. Sorry. Opa.
Next person already left for the United States, so is now joining, hopefully, on Zoom. Eric, are you there? Well, maybe it's muted. So the second student is Eric Arguello from Ecuador. The title of his thesis was Anti-de Sitter Traversable Wormholes under the supervision of Kyriakos Papadodimas, and I see Eric on Zoom, so let's congratulate him.
Congratulations, Eric.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Then we have Samir Belaloui from Algeria. The title of this thesis was Evolution of the Cosmic Microwave, a neutrino background, and Physics Beyond the Standard Model under the supervision of Alexei Smirnov. Samir, is there?
Congratulations.
Now we have Mina'il Bhutt from Pakistan. Her work was about axion dark matter under the supervision of Giovanni Villadoro. Congratulations. Then we have Carlo Cruz Sanchez from Peru. His thesis was about quantum field theory's consistency from scattering amplitudes under the supervision of Joan Elias Miró. Wait a second. The supervisor is coming.
OK, great. You go that way. No, you go there. Yeah. He's in the middle. Yeah, you can come a bit closer. Yeah, that's OK. Congratulations.
So we now have Ahmed El Sherbini from Egypt. His thesis was about cosmological perturbations and the inflationary theory under the supervision of Paolo Creminelli, with myself, and Vicharit Hincharoenrat.
He's here. Congratulations, Paolo, also.
Now we go to Mongolia. We have Erdene Bulgan Lagvadori. And her thesis was about sterile neutrino, dark matter, and neutrino mass generation under the supervision of Alexei Smirnov.
Yes.
The next one is Arpon Paul from Bangladesh. He already left for the United States, so he should be on Zoom. Let's wait if he appears. In the meanwhile, I read the thesis. Semi-classical ground state wave function using three-level Witten diagrams under the supervision of Merdad Mirbabai. Congratulations, Arpon. And last but not least, we have Safwan Yaqub from Bahrain. I think he's not present, so congratulate anyway. And his thesis was about reconstructing black hole interior from the CFT under the supervision of Kyriakos Papadodimas. Congratulations also to Safwan.
It's quite amazing that we have not repeated a country so far. Right? All the countries have been different.
Okay, we continue with condensed matter students. I would like to congratulate Ms. Julia Basila from Congo. She did her diploma work entitled Lipid Bilayers as Model Plasma Membrane, Experimental Theoretical Synergy to Tactile Increasing Complexity, under supervision of Ali Hassan Ali and Loredana Casalis. Please wait, Loredana is coming. Please wait a little bit.
Ali is coming?
Loredana is coming.
Hello, Loredana. Hi. Hello. Congratulations.
So the next is Joshua Casapao from Philippines. He defended his thesis multipartite entanglement dynamics across a superfluid insulator phase transition under the supervision of Alessandro Silva. Joshua?
Hi.
Congratulations, Joshua.
The next is Ms. Maha Sunan from Tunisia, and she did her diploma work entitled Control of the Exchange Coupling in Graphene-Based Synthetic Antiferromagnets, a Density Functional Study, under supervision of Natasha Stoich. Thank you, Maha. Thank you, Natasha.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
So the next is Ms. Pilushka Barakole from Uganda. And her postgraduate diploma work entitled Monolayer of Molybdenum Disulfide for the Hydrogen Evolution Reaction, a perspective based on density functional theory, is done under the supervision of Ralph Gebauer.
So congratulations for this. Congratulations.
The next is Ms. Lien Le from Vietnam. And her thesis, a heterojunction of transition metal dihalcogenides, a computational view on interface, was done at the supervision of Ralph Gebauer. Lien, Ralph, thank you so much.
How do you say your name? Too late?
Yes,
Lien Tille. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And the next is Valerius Ligasetiavan from Indonesia. He did his thesis entanglement detection utilizing moments of partial transpose under supervision of Marcello da Buonte, Vittorio Vitale, and Giuseppe Santoro. So Marcello and Giuseppe are here.
Okay, come here. Face this way. Congratulations. Come here. Congratulations.
So the next is Jonah Nagura from Nigeria, and his thesis, Optical Properties of Organic Dyes, the Role of Solvation, is done under supervision of Ralph Gebauer. So the next is Rolando Ramirez Camasca from Peru. He did his thesis, Transport Properties of Disordered SU2 Symmetric Spin Chains, under supervision of Antonella Scardicchio.
Rolando.
And we have Ms. Pooja Thapa from Nepal, and her thesis, Interaction of Water Molecules with Two-Dimensional Materials, Density Function Approach, is done under supervision of Ralph Gebauer.
Congratulations, Ralph, for four students. Congratulations, Pooja.
Thank you very much, and my congratulations. So we proceed with our system physics.
Hi, everyone. So I'd like to start by congratulating all of you. It's been a difficult year, but we made it together, and we're all very happy for you. So we can start with Grace Afram, who's in the US, I believe, and she's joining us on Zoom. She did a work on our monthly and interannual cloud radiative forcing variations, good proxies for long-term cloud climate feedbacks, supervised by Adrian Tompkins.
Together.
She's not connected?
Okay. It would look like it's your thesis.
Yes, thank you very much.
You finally made it.
Okay.
Where's Grace? Is she not online?
Ah, perfect.
Congratulations, Grace.
Okay. Congratulations,
thank you.
Grace.
Yeah.
Everything's going okay there?
Seems so. Next, also on Zoom, is Aminat Ambelorum. Did a thesis on covariances between Barents-Kara December sea ice anomaly index and atmospheric circulation anomalies on interannual scale, supervised by Fred Kuhaski. And the next one is Kayode Ayegbuzi, who did a thesis on investigating the impact of El Nino Southern Oscillation on monthly extreme climate conditions in Africa, supervised by Fred Kuhaski. Next is Michi Bianca de Vera with a thesis on a new look at sea surface temperature hotspots, convective organization, and the diurnal cycle in tropical Western Pacific observations, supervised by Adrian Tompkins.
And she's present.
Next is Alejandra Quintanilla, did a thesis on study of improvements and persistent biases in the modeling of the Humboldt current system, analyzing the SIMI-5 and SIMI-6, supervised by myself.
Congratulations, Alejandra.
Next is Amelia Sanchez. The other is an Atlantic warm pool in SIMI 6 models and observations, again supervised by myself.
Congratulations, Amelia.
And next is Dung Vu, with a thesis on measuring group velocity dispersion curves using ambient noise cross correlations, supervised by Karima Udia and Sadeghi.
Congratulations.
And finally, Tofik Yakubu, with a work on application of receiver function technique and ambient noise tomography in central Apennines, supervised by Karim Audia and Daniel Manumorf.
now, Lothar, please, the floor is yours.
So, good afternoon, and congratulations to all of you. So, the first one is Rahama Sani Abdullahi from Nigeria. She's not here. She did the whole program from home in Nigeria. So the title of her thesis is Towards the Sharp Hausdorff-Young's Inequality, and the supervisor was Emmanuel Canero.
Congratulations, Rahama.
Thank you.
So now we have Younes Ben Yahia from Algeria. The title of his project was Vector Bundles and the Chern-Weil Theory, under supervision of Pavel Putrov. Okay. No, he should be here. He should be here, but then he isn't. Yeah, anyway, I'm sorry.
He's not for the next one, yeah.
Okay.
What should we do? I mean, should we? We can take the photo later, maybe.
So, next one is A.J. Gautam from Nepal. And the title of his project was An Introduction to Hilbert Schemes of Points, under my supervision.
Yes, please. Sorry. We hold it together. We hold it together like this.
Okay, thanks.
Congratulations, Ajay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We have Huba Hussein from Egypt. The title of her thesis was A Study of SRB Measures on Axiom A Attractors, under the supervision of Stefano Luzzatto.
She's not here.
Who is not here? I don't know whether Huba is. No. Okay. This was Huba. No, I had already done Gautam. Now come. Yes, I've done it. So anyway, she's not here. So okay. We'll go ahead. So the next one is Min Hao Ling from Malaysia, and he did his thesis on block structured random matrices under the supervision of Jacopo Grilli.
Congratulations, man.
So now comes Mirmuksin Makhmudov from Uzbekistan, and he did his project with Stefano Luzzatto on topological pressure and its relationship with invariant measures.
Congratulations, man. Sorry, come back.
Now comes Toluwani Okunola from Nigeria, and she did her project again with Stefano Luzzatto on the existence and approximation of the unique physical measure of the Manneville-Pomeau map.
Okay.
Okay. Next comes.
No?
So I don't mention it? Okay. So next comes von Pitak Trakudit from, so I mean, I think that doesn't work. Von Pitak Trakudit, who is not here, he also did his project from home, his whole year from home, and his project was on spaces of constant curvature under the direction of Claudia Rezzo and Alessandra Ottiman.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations,
Frank. I saw him.
Thank you.
Anyway,
they have put on check relations.
No, he's there. Before we also have Unite Ratzak from Pakistan, who did his project on link invariance and Hopf algebra under the direction of Pavel Putev. Okay, thank you very much.
So now we proceed with quantitative life science. Antonio.
So you made it finally, right? Great. So let's start with Saeed Azizi from Afghanistan, who made his final project on invariant object recognition based on pixel representation under the supervision of Jean Barbier and David Zoccolan. Then we have Dionessa Biton from the Philippines, who worked on olfactory search with reinforcement learning using long short-term memory networks under my supervision and with the help of Emanuele Panizon. And then we have Ana Forero Pinto from Colombia, mathematical models of proliferative control under my supervision and that of Alberto Pugliafito. Next we have Idriss Quadri from Algeria, numerical study of stochastic belief propagation under supervision of Jean Barbier.
Next, Boris Nafak
from Cameroon, investigating the emergence of convolution from invariants under the supervision of Alessandro Ingrosso.
Congratulations, Boris.
And we have Ivana Rondon from Venezuela, cell size control in non-stationary conditions under the supervision of Jacopo Grilli. Next is Jonathan Sarmiento from Venezuela, stochastic models of stem cell division under the supervision of Edgar Roldan.
Thank you.
We close with Kairel Verano from the Philippines, a reinforcement learning approach to spider ballooning under my supervision and with Emanuele Pazzi.
Congratulations, Kairel.
Congratulations to you all. You all students, you should be exceptionally proud to have made it in such a extenuating circumstances, so difficult, okay? So we are really, really very proud of you.
Congratulations. I should stay there. How does it? How do they? They stay there. Okay. Okay.
Today. So now it's time to award the best students of the year in each section. So we first start with high energy. There are two best students. Eric Aguello, he's selected by Zoom. Congratulations, Eric.
Congratulations, Eric.
Congratulations. And the best student is Apron Paul, the best high energy student. So he's also connected by Zoom. Our congratulations, Apron.
Congratulations, Arpan.
This year is really exceptional. We also have two best students in condensed matter section. So I would like to call Joshua Casapao from Philippines.
Congratulations. catch you soon.
Congratulations, Joshua.
And we call Rolanda Ramirez Camasca from Peru as the best condensed matter student of 2020-2021. So in Earth system physics, we call Michi Bianca de Vera from Philippines.
Congratulations, Michi.
Thank you.
The best 2020-2021 students in mathematics is Ajay Gautam from Nepal. Ajay is connected by Zoom.
Congratulations, Ajay.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And in quantitative life science, the best students for 2020-2021 academic year is Kirill Verano from Philippines. Okay, and I think now it's time for students to say and share with us your experience, good experience, bad experience, share your impressions. As usual, we start with high energy. If there is someone from high energy who wants to say something to everybody, please.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. I'm not preparing anything, so bear with me a little bit. Most of you know me, not because of my cuteness, of course, but because most of the Adriatic warnings was because of me. Sorry about that. This year has been really hard and really difficult on all of us in many aspects. Assignments, exams, running after bus number 6 a lot. many aspects. And if I talking about the hard times, of course, I cannot ignore Giovanni's oral exam. Like, no one can ignore that. Lots of hard and difficult times. But personally, this year was hard for me for a couple of personal reasons. One of them is that I lost one of my family members and also my professor. But instead of finding pressure, instead of finding people who are eager to get the assignment, actually the coordinator asked me to come, and he asked me what we can do, what the ICTP can offer. That is really important to mention because this reflects what the ICTP is really is. It is not just a place where you go and have some lectures and do some assignments. It's much more than this. It's a home. It's a home for science, and it's also a home for scientists. It is really important to mention that. So from here, I want to thank all of the ICTP members, all of the ICTP staff. I don't want to forget anyone. And for sure, my supervisor, Professor Paolo, thank you for standing by me all day, all in the darkest hours and in the hardest days. I remember in the first meeting of the thesis, it was really bad that Professor Paolo was like, not too bad. But of course, his face was like he was having a stroke. So thank you for surviving through all of this. It is really hard to be a brilliant scientist, but it's even harder to be a good man. So thank you for being a good man as you are, a brilliant scientist for sure. And if I really wanted to say something that I want to be here, it would be the following. For the upcoming students, for all the people hearing me now, always be fearless. Never be afraid of anything. Never be afraid of lose anything. Most of the cruel and the brutal deeds in the history of mankind have been done out of fear and weakness, not out of the person who have done it is a bad person. Always try to be the best version of yourself. Always try to be yourself, because that is the most noble thing you can do. Enjoy the journey. Don't just stuck to the list of targets that you set and forget to enjoy the journey, because at the very end, if you achieved all of your goals and you didn't get to enjoy the journey, I doubt you will be satisfied. And of course, I can't thank much my wolf pack, the HECAP section, all of my friends who made this year special more than I can imagine. Thank you all of beautiful memories, well, crazy memories, not just beautiful. I mean, guys jumping in the middle of December in a frozen water, that's crazy, it's just crazy. lots of memories. Thank you for all of this. And maybe I want to say this from Rudyard Kipling. One of Rudyard Kipling quotes was, "What is moral? Who rides may read when the night is thick and the tracks are blind. A friend at a bench is a friend indeed, but a fool to wait for a lagger behind. Down to Jinn or up to the throne, I travel the fastest when I travel alone." Congratulations to you all, and go conquer the world. Thank you.
More speech from Pyenergy. Please, don't be shy. If you want to say something, please. So, condensed matter.
Yeah, this is your chance to get back to your professors.
So Lian wants to say something. Please.
Good afternoon, professors, staffs, families connecting online, alumni, my friends, and my colleagues of Diploma 2021. It's my honor to stand in front of you today. When I first came to ICTP, like other students, I was driven to excel, to be the best in academics. And the diploma programs really brings me the competitive side, our independence, and the drive to push our boundaries. We may see how those qualities serve us well by looking at the success of diploma alumni. But is that the success in academics is all we need to have a happiness in life? It's not until recently that I realized happiness doesn't just come from academic achievements, but mainly from the relationship with people around us, to let them into our lives and reaching out to support the community. Feeling at home is not what I expected when I first came to ICTP, which is more than 5,000 miles far away from my home country, Vietnam. But this happened to me. I still remember the first day CMSP students attend the class in person. Professor Kiselev went to the Galileo guest house to take us to the Leonardo building. It was really a warm and touching moment, which reminds me of the past when my parents took me to the school. Let me ask you some questions. How many of you still feel sad now because of getting C in the course? Or the sadness just lasts for some days and then it fades away? But how many of you regret losing the contact with a close friend or missing the chance to continue collaborating with a friendly colleague? If I have the chance to meet Nobel laureates, I'll ask them whether the Nobel Prize is the motivation for them to work happily with full of joy every day. I guess the answer is no. Then I'll ask them whether the beauty of science is the only motivation that drives them to work tirelessly every day. Against all the difficulties that they encounter while conducting research? Or is that the boundless inspiration, warm encouragement, sense of optimism from their colleagues play a bigger part in motivating every day working day? The COVID pandemic somehow illustrates how important it is to have your colleagues beside. Research will go much smoother when you usually exchange ideas with your colleagues. Even some jokes, friendly smiles encourage you to continue working when you are stuck. It is of enormous importance for someone to let in a community, and at ICTP, I do believe no one has the feeling of an outsider. The COVID pandemic also allows us to see how people in ICTP community taking care of others. I still remember it was in early 2020. I was still a bachelor student and hadn't had any chance to come to ICTP. However, one day I saw a call for donation spreading out almost all the groups of Vietnamese scientists with the title, donation to ICTP with the hope to relieve the negative impact of COVID pandemics. The list of the donors are public. It's a long list, including associate professors, long-term visiting scientists, postdocs, diploma students, or visitors, with many well-known names, such as Dan Thanh Son, Dirac medalist, Ngô Bảo Châu, field medalist. I was more curious about ICTP since then because I was wondering how an institution has been affecting the development of science in Vietnam throughout many generations like that, and why people, once has been being at ICTP, has such sense of strong bonding to it. And now I can confidently say that I know the reason. Vietnamese scientists at ICTP is just a representative sample of the ICTP community in any other countries. And I do believe ICTP community in any other countries also share that spirit. ICTP is really an ideal community where people can let in and reach out to others. This kind of motto is attached to everyone once you were at ICTP. You may see this by also looking back the 30 years anniversary these days. People even spreading out all over the world, once at ICTP, all connect and reconnect. to class of Diploma 2021, I firmly believe we can let in ICTP whenever we are in need. And that's our honor and our responsibility to be the ambassadors of building the community stronger and stronger. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Lien. Anybody else who wants to speak from condensed matter? Then those system physics.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is an honor to be here at our graduation and celebrating the 30th anniversary of the diploma program. It is weird to be here in front of all of my colleagues and authorities for the first time after a year of being here and almost the last year of our diploma. I still remember the first time that we get out of the Galileo guest house and start walking around looking for the cafeteria and how we start meeting each other. That same day, we have to go to the postal office to get the permit of stay, which was our first task. And it was tricky because of the language, a new city, a different culture. We get lost in the bus and having no clue who was the Sportello amigo. Still, in the end, we managed to discover how it was working as a team. This year was challenging for all of us, but I'm glad that we spent it together. I'm always going to be grateful to all of you because no matter how different we are or think, you always had a smile on your face and give some words of motivation. Thank to the ICTP for taking the challenge that means having the diploma this year. We know how difficult it was trying to make all the activities, trying to be as usual as they can be given the situation, the circumstances. Well, someone said, Iñigo Loyola said once, when you get the excellence, you must share it. And I think that's the spirit of the center and what they try to share with all of us and with the world. I want to thank all our teachers because having online classes is not an easy task. In every lesson, we notice the hard work that you put into it, and we really appreciate that. You always try harder to make us be involucrated in the different subjects, and it really works. But more importantly, I want to thank all my classmates. All of you have been wonderful, and I'm really going to miss you. I will never forget our reunions and parties and how we reunion to work together for a study for exam or making the assignments. I'm looking for the moment that we all meet together, and I'm pretty sure all of you are going to have a bright future. Finally, I want to share some words, a phrase from a Mexican composer, Juan Gabriel, which is in Spanish, la vida nos da la oportunidad de superarnos, y si llegamos a ser grandes, entonces nunca moriremos, which literally translates to, life gives us the opportunity to improve ourselves, and if we become great, then we will never die. So let's work very hard, so that our work lasts forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Alejandra. Somebody else from our system physics? So, mathematics. Who is going to say something? Other volunteers? Well, many people are connected by Zoom. Maybe somebody wants to speak by Zoom. If so, please unmute your microphone. Arpon?
Yes, so can you hear me?
Yes, we can, please.
Yeah, so it was great to be a part of this ICTP diploma program. And basically in my first term of this diploma program, I had to attend this program from my home because there was some COVID restriction. And I came in at ICTP in January this year, And I should say, like, the first 4 or 5 months continuing this program from home, it was totally different when I came to ICTP, because the environment of ICTP was really great to, like, to be with the professors and my wonderful classmates, and also the PhD students, postdocs, to have lunch with them, to talk about physics. And also, for example, because all the diploma students, we have been at the Adriatic guest house, it actually helped us to have a wonderful bonding. For example, we went to dinner together, and after the dinner, we used to play ping pong for an hour, maybe sometimes. And it was great, actually. And I'll mostly miss the people I met there at ICTP. And it was a wonderful 1 year. And thank you for being such a nice community. Hope to see you again in future sometime. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Arpon. I would like to give a floor to students from Quantitative Life Science. Who is going to speak? Kirill?
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. And for those connected in Zoom, to the families and friends of my colleagues, good morning or good evening, whatever is the time there. So my speech is a little bit different, because I will just want to express my gratitude and share not only my experience, but my colleagues also from QLS. So I'm very happy to, nervous but happy to be here today to say our thanks. First of all, we want to thank ICTP for giving us this wonderful opportunity. Some people, when I was traveling here, some people would tell me, are you crazy? Why are you moving to a country, in a foreign country in this time? For some, it would be a crazy idea, but for each one of us, it is a risk that we were willing to take, because we want this opportunity to grow or to learn more and to advance our studies in science. So thank you very much, ICTP, that despite all the challenges, you managed to bring us all here, or most of us here. Thank you also for the wonderful provision for us, for doing your best also to make our life more manageable in this pandemic. So I wouldn't imagine how I would study in a foreign country if I don't have an ICTP family. So thank you for providing us a family far away from home. Thank you. We would like also to thank our director for sometimes checking up on us and asking us what we need during our Zoom meetings. We want to thank also our secretariat, Ms. Sandra and Ms. Patricia. Thank you very much for always being able to respond to our requests, sometimes silly requests, but thank you very much for your patience. For all the staff from Visa to medical office, everyone in ICTP was very helpful, and we thank you so much. And for our professors and tutors, they're here. I'm so happy that you're all here today, almost. Thank you so much for imparting us not just your knowledge in quantitative life sciences, but also your passion in science, in doing research. It wasn't the normal setup, but I really think that you really did a great job to prepare the lessons, to record the lectures in advance. And it was very helpful for us how you have provided us a lot of opportunities to learn in different ways. through the recorded lectures, and then we had a question and answer. It was very helpful for us to give us time to think, to give us time to process the things that you taught us, and for us to really critically think. It was a different experience from mine, because we usually sit in the classroom and just listen. And before I came here, I barely asked questions from my professors. And I just, sometimes I'm just so shy to ask questions. But here, during our lessons, the way they taught us, it pushes me to think more and to really ask if I didn't understand something. So thank you very much for all your effort. It's super great. And thank you also for our families who are supporting from all over the world. Hello to everyone. Thank you for your support, for sending us here with your love also. And I can imagine how difficult it is for them also, for you also, for us to be away from you. And we would like to thank you for your patience, for supporting our dreams and our aspirations in our pursuit in science. And to my fellow diploma students, thank you very much for everything. So I didn't just gain colleagues during this day, but we have made friends and family. So I think all of you as a part of my family now. Thank you very much. And I always joke to some of you, oh, one day, if I work in a university in the Philippines, I should know your research, and I will invite you to speak in my university, because that would be a great inspiration for the Filipino youth also. So I hope you would grant my request in the future. So thank you very much for supporting each other. Thank you for saying hi. Even the simple act of saying hi is so warm in our hearts, because we have been staying a lot in our rooms. But whenever we go out, we joyfully say hi to each other. And to my QLS family, thank you for all our ups and downs. We are always there for each other, trying to help each other in all our struggles. Not just that, but in our learning, in our courses, I really think that I have you as my colleagues, because we have always this healthy conversation. Not healthy, sometimes we argue, but it's a good argument, because it pushes us more to think if what we're telling or our ideas are right or wrong. So thank you for being in this learning journey together. Okay, so just to share also my colleagues' experience, I ask them one word, so that you'll also learn one word from our native language to describe somehow, not fully describe, but somehow describe a part of our experience here in ICTP. So first one, I apologize if my pronunciation is wrong. Okay, first one is Zabardast, which means fantastic from Urdu. Yes. My colleague says, I entered the program to continue my studies, to learn more skills, but I ended up learning the true essence of research, which is collaboration. And I will be learning as a better version of myself. I will be living as a better version of myself, with skills that will help me in the future. And with that, I hope will be lifelong friendships, a QLS family. A second word is cinco estrellas from Spanish, which means five star. She said that this is what you usually say when you really like something and your rating is five stars. So she, her rating of her ICTP experience here is 5-star. And another Spanish word is cálido, which means warm in Spanish. So I think she explained it to be having the warmth as a family that ICTP provides, all the professors, all the staff, and the colleagues. A third Spanish word, we have three Spanish speakers in our group, is cooperación, or in English it means cooperation. So he said that it was a good experience to have a cooperative learning in all our courses. Another word in French, I'm not sure. La raisonnement, sorry. It means the reasoning. He said that the learning the ways to approach a problem is more important than achieving the result. So we have been, in our problem sets, we have been challenged to approach the problems in different ways. And in Persian, we have kalikob, which means very good. So it's so we hear this a lot from our professors, and we really feel so happy when we hear this. And at the same time, it's a very good experience for us. Very good program and very good and nice collection of very interesting topics that we learned in a short time. In Arabic, this is so difficult. Ra'er. Which means in English, great. So it's a great experience for us. And our professor also always say this to us. And yeah, this comments from our professor is a good motivation for us to continue to really push to learn more. And their feedbacks are very good. They help us a lot to improve for all the things that we lacked before. They give constructive criticisms to really improve us, not just in science, but also our attitude and how we present and how we write things. In Filipino, is the word makabuluhan, which means significant or insightful. It says here, the diploma program has been very insightful. We just didn't learn the courses as if in a book. But also the professors have given us so many creative insights on why studying such topics is very important. Also, the hardships in this year, the challenges, that it made us reflect that science still progresses despite the difficulty, and in general, we in our life should continue as well. And the last word from me is paglago, which means growth. So as we have grown so much in many aspects for this year, we thank our professors, we thank the ICTP community, but we also hope that this will jumpstart our full growth in our future careers as we promote scientific excellence in our home countries or wherever our future leads us. Thank you very much. And lastly, I want to thank my family, the Philippines. They are watching. And thank you to everyone who is in here. And last of all, I would like to bring back all the glory to God, our Creator.
Thank you. Thank you, Carol. So we also have our distinguished guests, alumni, former ICTP students, connected by Zoom. Maybe somebody wants to say something to us? If so, please unmute your microphone. Maybe there is somebody from audience who wants to say something. So, if not...
Hi.
Sorry?
Yes, this is GB Fall. I did the diploma in 2000, 2001. And great. I wanted to thank all the organizers of this great celebration for having this event, this reunion, which has been a wonderful reunion, a lot of reconnections. And thank ICTP for everything they're doing for the whole world. As I wrote in the chat yesterday, ICTP made a big impact in the world and has changed the world, or has contributed in changing the world through educating and promoting research, and through bringing people together and making the brainstorming even more diverse, just like to quote James Gates, to quote Abdul Salam through Dr. James Gates. This is a kind of a lot of DNA coming together to bring something like jazz into the not only physics but into the sciences. So I wanted to take that opportunity to thank ICTP for everything they are doing and they continue to do, and also to congratulate the new diploma students and tell them the sky is the limit, and they have the word. They can change the world. They can contribute to change the world, just like ICTP's mission to change the world. Thank you for this event, and thank you for these three wonderful days.
Thank you so much, Dr. Powell. Thank you. So maybe Paola will say a few words about, or Atish.
You go ahead. I just want to say a couple of words afterwards.
No, I would just then I say something about the time.
No, I just wanted to congratulate you, all of you, again. I think it has been a very nice ceremony for the last 2 days. And today we have, as you know, as a commencement speech, a lecture by the 2020 Physics Nobel Laureate, Andrea Ghez. So we all look forward to it, and I hope, and I'm sure you will be around. And then we get some time to have a party a little bit on the terrace. One thing I want to note is that this year we are particularly happy because about 47% of the students are women. So this is perhaps first time in the history of ICTP that we have reached almost 50% gender balance, which in the hard sciences, I think, like physics, is an achievement. So congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
Okay, so we now take a break, so there is a coffee break, I think. So please come back, so we reconvene for the program at 4:15, and then we have the commencement speech by Professor Andrea Ghez at 5. So please come back to the room. Thank you and congratulations.